In a previous screencast, I showed you how to calculate the heat flux between two infinite parallel plates with and without radiation shields. Here, we're going to look at the same system, but we're going to calculate the temperature of the radiation shields. We have these two infinite parallel plates with a radiation shield between them. And surface one has a temperature of 800 Kelvin and an emissivity of 0.6. Surface two has a temperature of 500 Kelvin and an emissivity of 0.7. Finally, our radiation shield, which we don't know the temperature of, has a very low emissivity of 0.02. Like we did before, we're going to use a circuit system, but this time instead of calculating the heat flux, which we already did for this system, we're going to use the same approach to calculate the temperature of the radiation shield. Note that the flux stays constant throughout the system, so we can look at any part of the system. So in this case, what we're going to do here is look at the system between surface one and the first surface of the radiation shield. So let's draw the circuit between them. So note we go from surface one here, acting as a black body, to surface three, which we're going to call the radiation shield. And then we have resistances based on the emissivity of material one or surface one, the view factor between the two surfaces, which is equal to one, and the resistance due to the emissivity of the first side of the radiation shield. So now we can write this as our flux is equal to our Stefan-Boltzmann constant, T1 to the fourth minus T3 to the fourth, divided by the sum of the resistances. So here we know what our heat flux is, and what we're trying to find is this temperature here. So let's put in our numbers. And so if we solve for T3, we find that the temperature of the radiation shield is equal to 696.5 Kelvin. Now let's take a look at it from the other side. In other words, the system between the other side of the radiation shield and the second surface. So let's see what that circuit looks like. So here we start at temperature three, which we're going to solve for and see if it's similar to the temperature we calculated by doing the first half of the circuit. Going to temperature two, which is the temperature of the second surface or 500 K. And if you note these resistances, this is the emissivity on the second half of the radiation shield. Here's our view factor between the shield and the second surface, which is one. And here's our resistance based on the emissivity of the second surface. If we put the numbers in here, and if we solve for our T3, this is going to be equal to 697.1 Kelvin, almost identical to the T3 that we calculated here.